Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright.
Welcome back, everybody. It's time for our final fun part of the evening, where we get to give back and say thanks to those who helped us along the way. We were on a Kickstarter earlier this year in sort of February, March, and part of that was some of the people who donated. We give them some big old shout-outs on stream.
And here we are. Yep. We made a studio.
We made a studio.
All by ourselves. If only you could see the beautiful facility we have here.
Oh, it's fantastic.
We have, like, egg crate. Hammered into the ceiling to absorb some of the sound, and there's like cheap, I don't even know what that is, like
black foam,
opaque stuff hung down to block the sunlight from our sunroom, and yeah, it's kind of ghetto in here, but it's a studio, and it looks nice on camera, right?
Yeah, so that's all that matters.
We have a bed.
The magic.
It's all thanks to you guys, as well as our Kickstarter supporters in particular, and on that note, let's thank them. So, this will be our last day of the shoutouts, but we do have more rewards sort of being fulfilled over the coming days.
Yep.
Start with, not Caveat Emptor, but Cave Bat Emptor. I don't know where to go with this one.
Cave Bat Emptor.
It's very clever.
What's an Emptor?
It's a Latin expression. I should know what it means.
Let's say, I think
it's Latin.
Cave Bat, I get, but...
Let the buyer beware.
Oh, okay, I didn't realize that wasn't it.
Let the buyer beware.
So, instead of Caveat, he made it Cave Bat.
Yeah, he's being cute.
Ah, I'm
onto
you.
So, well, you're very clever, obviously, much cleverer than we are. You're probably good-looking. You enjoy drinking whiskey, a fine scotch, perhaps, on the rocks, of course, and wearing some comfortable loafers. And
do you have your scotch on the rocks? Like a nice, like, just sit around, sip it scotch.
I like it with Coke. It's okay. Much more tasty, but on the rocks is okay if you just want to really feel the burn, so to speak. You know,
it's a pleasant burn. Yeah. I don't know.
It's not terrible. It's not vodka.
No.
That stuff is like drinking gasoline.
Okay.
Don't drink vodka.
All right.
Unless you're Russian, then I guess it tastes good.
Our next shout-out comes from a guy called Underer, who says, "Hey, I mostly play hard support in Captain's Mode game." Well, shout out to you. There needs to be more people who play support in games in general. Enigma and Rubick are my main heroes. Also, I suck at Dota so much it's not even funny.
Yeah.
I also have a Team Fortress 2 team, which we lose almost every league match which we play. None of this is really interesting, so just improvise a bit, I guess. I love you guys. Well,
you play support. That's interesting.
It's interesting that he admits that he sucks terribly at the game. Like,
because most
90%
don't.
Of the community think they're, like, hot shit.
Well, the Dunning-Kruger effect states that people, like, bad players think they're better than they are and worse,
yeah.
And good players think they're worse than they actually
yeah,
are.
Yeah, speaking of bad players, well, like, who are these guys?
It's actually, like, if you're intelligent, you tend to think you're not as smart as you are, but bad at Dota equals yeah. dumb and good at Dota equals smart, obviously, so.
Okay. There you go. All right.
And on that note, thank you very much, Underer. Our next one is Julia. I have no idea! Ha 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 ha! I wish that unicorns existed so that every day would be covered in pink candy floss and rainbow Skittles.
I just know who this is.
I love everything about Dota 2 and wish I was a pro gamer. LOL! But that would never happen! I love Navi and Gods. You're amazing!
I know who
My
this is.
My friends call me Pikachu. Thanks!
That wasn't girly enough. Where's your... We need like a...
Thanks!
Okay. Not bad. Big thanks to Julia, who I'm
friends with. Yeah, she tweets with us occasionally.
Yeah.
I haven't met her, but she seems like a very bubbly personality.
Yep. Very friendly
very
person.
Very bubbly.
Our next thanks and
Thank
shout-out goes to Thor181, and he says, "The dude." Wait, I think this is a dialogue. We may have to do this
from
one together. I haven't read this.
I think it's from The Big Lebowski.
Okay. I haven't seen The Big Lebowski.
The only way I remembered that is, like, I'm like, what's the one that the drinking game in college where you drink a lot of White Russians and don't smoke too many illegal drugs? Anyway, go ahead. You've never heard of the Lebowski Challenge? No. Lived in Australia, so it doesn't surprise me.
Are we doing this dialogue together, or am I doing this
side? All right, I'll be the stranger.
All right.
You be the dude.
Yeah, well, the dude abides.
No, it's not like that. It's like, yeah... Well, the dude abides.
All right, well, you fucking do both then. All right.
The dude abides. I don't know about you, but I take comfort in that. It's good knowing he's out there. The dude. Taking her easy for all us sinners. Shoosh. I sure hope he makes the finals.
All right.
Or.
Who am I going to butcher this time? I'll do Smokey.
Okay. Over the line!
Huh?
I'm sorry, Smokey, you were over the line. That's a foul.
Bullshit. Mark it 8, dude.
Excuse me, mark it 0. Next frame.
Bullshit, Walter. Mark it 8, dude.
Smokey, this is not NOM. This is bowling. There are rules.
I think we've taken the wrong career path, LD. In our element. If you don't know where the quote comes from, I want a refund. Fuck. Well, one of us knew. How does that count?
What?
He ended it where, if we don't know where the quote comes from, I want a refund.
I knew where it was from.
Okay, we're covered.
All right, you owe me whatever he donated to us.
Otherwise, looking forward to listening to the cast while I'm at work in the morning.
All right. Our next one is Whoopi. We should thank Thor. Thank you very much, Thor.
Yep.
181. Whoopi. Okay, this is just whoop-dass.
Yeah,
whoop-dass from BA, cyber-stalker of gods from his early casting. Good luck in the future.
I actually know this guy. He's a friendly guy. Chatted with him.
I like his name, whoop-dass with two Zs.
Yep. Back in the BAs, the Bored Aussies, where all the Australian Dota 1 players used to play.
Yeah.
So, some good old memories there. Our next shout-out, big thanks to whoop-dass, of course, comes from Jack Flood, and he says, "I'm Jack Flood. I'm 16, I believe that says, or is it 18? I think it's 16. And I pretty much go to school, listen to music, and play Dota. To be honest, there isn't much else to say. Wish you guys all the best with your studio, and I would have donated more if I had more money." You're 16, dude. You should be spending your $10 over on, like, giving it to your older siblings to buy you some, like, booze or something.
Yeah, that's one thing. I thought you were just going to say give it to your older siblings.
No.
It's fine by me, since I'm the oldest in my family. But
be like, give me
you're
some
the baby,
booze.
Right? Or
if you're 16 and...
But you have one older sister.
I have two younger sisters and one older sister. My older sister got me into...
So you're the authority
figure. Didn't get me in trouble, but...
More or less.
Not really.
Not
I have three sisters, so I didn't not have much authority. They would not listen to me.
My family was two sisters, two brothers, so
I quickly
constant learnt, gender wars.
I quickly learned that the you don't hit girls thing does not apply at all. Like, that, no.
Well, at your age, I think it applies. No. Maybe not when you're 15 or whatever. All right, our next one, oh boy. I get this one, huh? This is Ellie55. Polish clinical psychologist with a black man's lower parts of the body. Pray for me that I can find a decent laptop in Eastern Europe, spelled Y-R-U-P.
Europe.
Yirup. Because my old one just died. And much more love from me to you. No homo. Hugs and kisses, XOXOXO.
Well, I'm glad he can give back. I mean, this very well-endowed clinical psychologist, so...
I've never seen that spelling of Europe before. Y-R-U-P. That's like some next level, you know. Remember when, like, texting first came out on phones and you'd get, like, a limited number of messages per month, so you'd always want to conserve your characters?
Yes.
That reminds me of one that happened. Not an issue anymore.
All right.
For most of us.
Our next one comes from Marjinx. And Marjinx doesn't say too much about him or herself, but I imagine Marjinx is a very kind person out there who loves the Dota team very much, including us. So a big thanks to Marjinx.
Thank you, Marjinx. Maybe a Pokemon player. Jinx, not my favorite Pokemon.
Jinx is like one of the worst Pokemon.
It's like one of the ugliest ones, too. Yeah. It's like this very... It's like... It looks like a doll, except it's like a fat doll that has like pasta
That's
hair.
Racist.
Like, it's just like someone took like cooked pasta and taped it to the head. It is not an attractive Pokemon. Why would you use that when you can have like Charmander or Alakazam or something nice?
I don't know.
Yeah, we're staying away from that, Jarrett, because we're trying to be politically correct here and respectful. You are trying to take us in a bad direction.
All right.
Anyway.
Our next one.
Moving right along.
Our next one comes from Mauricio A. Rodriguez, I believe. And he says, a longtime Dota player, even though he still sucks, he played when Malevolence didn't exist. Ginsu was formed by Oblivion Staff and Soul Booster. The good old days. Razor had a Frenzy skill and Lina too. Drow's ultimate was something really useless. Dude, that Drow ultimate was the bomb. I love that. Killed any creep or something like that. For those of you who don't know, it used to have like a 10% chance of one-shotting a creep.
Oh, yeah. So you just get like mass attack speed items and go YOLO mode in the jungle.
You'd go like Mask of Madness and just jungle Drow, and whenever it proc, you would heal like 200 HP because it whatever the full HP of that creep.
Yeah,
block.
It like did the full damage for the health.
So you just straight up jungle Drow Ranger and go. It would scale like 10, 15, then 20%.
She was also really bad, but she was even worse than she is now.
She's
but it was
still
fun.
Bad, but
the best was the old Lifestealer or Nyx. Yeah. He was like, he had like three passives, and then his ult was a 20-second rage, I believe.
Yeah. Yes.
20 seconds of magic immunity.
Well, and he played back when Arcane Ring still existed. Blink Dagger was a Blink Dagger of Escape. You couldn't actually disable it by taking damage.
That used to be the old meta. And there'd be 10 Blink Daggers every game.
Yes, every hero would buy Blink for initiation, escape, and everything. Dota was a very different game, and I'm glad the way it's evolving. Back then, I had no way to follow any kind of competitive scene. Nowadays, it's easy and funny, partially because of you guys. Wish you the best success and a lot of great games to cast with Divine Rapier and Throne Races, because why not, right?
Thank you, Mauricio. Just read this out, says Lauren Shimshoot. Okay, anyway. Shout out from numbers to everyone in the Two Fort, Two Furious community. All of you are wonderful people, and I hope there are many more wonderful years to come. And also a special shout out to Tiny Hands and all the other Dota players at 2F2F. I hope we can still have fun playing Dota 2 instead of raging over everything that goes wrong. Looking at you, Francis. Looking at you. Also, a special haiku for Tits McGee. Live on, Dota 2. Long ago, haiku contest. Your friendship, my prize. Thank you, Lauren.
It sounded like Lauren beat Tits McGee in a haiku contest and is now trying to rub it in using the shout-out. I like it.
It's very disrespectful.
No, that's some fantastic play.
I'm on Tits McGee's side on this one.
You just like Tits McGee.
That's a great name.
You're just a tits guy.
That's a great guy.
I see how it is.
No. That's just a great name.
Well, you can have Tits McGee. I'll take Lauren.
Okay. Doesn't sound like a good deal.
Next shout-out.
By the way, I just want to interrupt this to say that Bulba is now taking credit for the Elder Titan Tinker. Isn't it amazing how Bulba has invented like every single professional strategy but hasn't won an international? How do you invent every new strategy?
Bulba should have invented winning the international.
Yeah. Like, he didn't think that far ahead, did he?
He's clearly doing it wrong.
That's like when you get three wishes from the genie, and then one of your wishes is retarded. Like, I want a really nice car instead of wishing for, you know,
more
being
wishes.
Almighty and all-powerful.
Yeah. Anyways, our next shout-out comes from Matthias. He's from Denmark. Loves Dota 2. He plays under the nickname of Aaron and Arendt Ved in the Twitch chat. Hello, Arendt Ved, if you're in the Twitch chat. His birthday is the 30th of March, so it's in a week as of today. You can see when we did these, it was back on the 23rd of March. But here we are, some 7 months later, and fulfilling our Kickstarter shout-outs.
Better late than never.
He's 16 years old, so quite a young guy. He plays a lot of Dota 2. He's a big fan of the competitive scene. His favorite team is the Q-Pad Red Pandas. I'm sorry for your loss there, as they've since gone. And whatever team Crit is playing for, since he's a close friend of Crit, who is currently playing on Team Life, I believe.
Yeah, they've changed team names a lot.
He enjoys playing solo mid and any other role and hopes to one day play competitive himself. His favorite hero is Storm Spirit, and he's glad he could help our Kickstarter and wish us the best of luck with our studio. Okay.
Thank you, Matthias.
And good luck becoming pro. At 16, I mean, you're still young, so learn all you can from Crit.
Lots of time to screw up.
Yep.
Our next one is from Mr. Kurt Armstrong. If you watched the G League and you weren't watching it here, this was way back in December, January, you may have heard him casting with Tobiwan.
Yep.
He is Z Muffin Man, and he wants to shout out his own personal social media. It's twitch.tv/ZMuffinMan, twitter.com/ZMuffinManDota, and youtube.com/ZMuffinManDota.
He's basically like the Bulba of Australia. Like, for those of you who don't know Z Muffin Man, like,
the Bulba of Australia.
He's like,
I can get behind that.
The best player in Australia, quote unquote, best player. He invented everything as far as metagame goes.
And anyone who's better than him, he discovered them. So.
Yes. Exactly. He's the Australian Bulba equivalent. So, big thanks to Curdy.
Thank you. He probably invented Bulba too, right?
Yeah, probably. I mean, what? Australia came well before America.
What a mistake that was.
Australia invented America, I believe.
What? Why would you invent...
That was also a mistake, America.
Why would you invent Bulba? Why would you do that to Dota? The fuck, Kurt?
What have you gone wrong? Our next shout out, though. Thank you, Kurt. Comes from Chubbacool. He says, "Hey, Greekfire here. If you can give a shout out to my boyfriend, Teddy Westside, that would be great. Thank you. P.S. I'm not a girl, so." Big shout out to Greekfire's boyfriend, Teddy Westside. Dota 2, we promote all different sexual orientations, so.
Yeah.
No problems there.
As long as you give us your money, we don't care.
Yeah.
We'll take it.
You pay us $10 and we'll promote your.
Well, maybe even change our own sexual orientation. Just. See how much money that takes.
We're flailing on stream yesterday, so.
I was pretty much like a sex change. Or no. Sexual orientation change. I guess those are two different things.
Look, for $10, we'll promote your agenda.
No, no. We're firing on all standards here. But seriously, shout out to Teddy Westside. Thank you to Chubbacool. And on that note, it's Grandmaster B-Funk. I am a fellow Australian. I hope the gods knows how to finish this sentence. I'll let you do this.
Oh, you have to do half of it. You do the first half.
Aussie.
You what? You missed an Aussie.
Okay. Aussie.
Oi, oi, oi.
Aussie.
Oi, oi, oi.
Okay.
And then it goes Aussie, oi, Aussie, oi, Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi. It's like the Australian chant at sports games.
Okay.
You hear it at any Australian national sports game. He's also the best player in the legit pro team, the YOLO Swaggers. With a name
That's
like
a great
that,
name.
MLG would not allow that shit though.
And he says,
nope.
Be prepared to cast our immense swag when we hit the pro leagues. Well, we'll be here when you hit the pro leagues.
Just don't try and play MLG. They will iron fist. You're not allowed that name.
No YOLO, no swagger, no swag.
Yep. Strictly no swag.
And definitely no demon, apparently. Brutal. They take no prisoners, those MLG folks. Okay, we're coming down to the home stretch here, gods.
Oh, wow.
Just a few more.
All right. Well, our next one comes
Make
from...
Make them count.
R.Y. Premo, he doesn't have a whole lot to say. In fact, he said absolutely nothing, but a big thanks. He did take the time to fill out our form for us, so...
I do love that. The ones who, like, took the time to fill it out and leave it blank. Maybe they meant to make us freestyle.
Yeah.
So what do you have to say about this guy?
I'm not sure. R.Y. Premo.
Or gal. Is it a guy?
I think it's a guy, mostly because 94%...
The odds are good.
Yeah, according to our YouTube, I think 96% of our viewership are male.
Yeah.
But obviously a very attractive male. I imagine this guy's as well endowed as our German clinical psychologist.
No, Polish.
Polish, sorry.
Polish.
With
the genitalia of a black person, I think
yeah.
He specified.
He's just a general nice guy as well. I imagine he's stunning.
That was like a really roundabout way to say I have a big penis.
Yeah.
Anyway. Well, thank you, Rive Primo, for not subjecting us to that.
Yes. I'd much prefer the blank slate.
Although now we're back on the subject, so. Next one up is Gustav Rommel, and he says, I am a Swedish law student. Of course, I am a rather terrible Dota player. Other than that, I will trust in your ability to make up something fun, and I'll be watching it before going out and take a drink for everything you get hilariously wrong. Well, if he's going out drinking at 3:30, then he must really be a law student, because, you know, law lawyers are alcoholics, right?
Yeah. So. You have to be an alcoholic to be a lawyer, so, I'm pretty sure.
Right now, it's like 3:30 p.m. in Sweden, and
okay.
He's drinking. Thank you, Gustav. And
well, we've been drinking for cheers. The last 3 hours, and it's like 6:30 a.m. here. Yeah. So,
I'm drunk on weird Dota.
Yeah, we didn't quite get the Earthshaker blocking today, but
it was close. Some of those. I mean, if we could see what was going on in that game, it would have been better. But yeah. Can't have everything, guys.
All right. Well, our next shoutout comes from Penny, and this is a good one. Hi, this shoutout isn't for me, but it's for my boyfriend Theo, who goes by Soldier online. He loves red pandas, Storm Spirit, Snoop Dogg, and Sexy Nurse Succubi.
Whoa.
This sounds like a good girlfriend.
Sexy Nurse Succubi. I think it's a succubus, but... Oh, he's saying he loves plural. Okay. So he's got he's got multiple Sexy Nurse Succubis. Or succubi.
Wow, his girlfriend really is open to many things.
She's a swinger as well as a sexy nurse.
Please tell him what an awesome Dota player and all-around cool person he is. Also, if one or both of you could blow him a kiss, I'm sure it would make... both of our days. Because you're such a great Dota player and an all-around cool guy.
Thank you, Leany Pen.
It's got the luminous seal of approval, his Dota playing skills. Congrats on reaching your goal, and good luck from Penny.
Okay, so our next one is... I just want to read the chat. The chat is so homophobic.
The question is, Penny doesn't specify what could be a boyfriend
well,
as well.
Well, it's to her boyfriend, and we're both guys, so...
No, I'm saying, like, the last one he said, oh, big shout out to my boyfriend. By the way, I'm not a girl. Yeah. Do we actually know Penny's a girl?
Leany. Leany sounds like a girl's name, right? I think so.
Probably. We're open to anything, but grills on the BTS stream, very rare.
You have to be good-looking. I mean, it doesn't matter what gender you are, but as long as you're good-looking, we'll consider you.
Okay.
Anyway, next one up is Knowledge Reigns Supreme. No info here, haha. Best of luck, guys. Joel. How can your name be Knowledge Reign Supreme and then you just have no knowledge to be dropped?
No info.
He's not living up to his name. Or maybe he's just an honest guy. Like, he doesn't have knowledge, so he's not bullshitting you and, like, pretending he has knowledge, like some casters.
I think this guy's being very dubious. I think he's actually out to, like, take over the world right now. But I'm not sure.
This is the next level.
Big thanks to you, Joel.
My head's getting twisted up in knots a little bit.
Our next one comes from Underer. I think haven't we already had one from Underer? It sounds familiar.
Oh, yeah, but we can shout him out again.
No, don't worry. I'm not complaining. I've lost it.
I mean, he's had to wait 5 months for
this. This is the guy who plays a lot of hard support.
Six months.
He says, I've already written a message like this before, but I just have to add that Purge casted a match of mine today for 2,200 viewers and that my team lost that match in 4 minutes. He said this is the support player who said he's really bad at Dota. Well, if you lose to Purge at 4 minutes.
Jesus. Well, Under, I hope you've gotten over it in the ensuing 7 months, but if not, I do feel for you. I guess it's only 5 or 6.
So, someone's done the stats. According to our 4% female statistic, that means there's 600 hot grills in our chat right now. We've got 10k viewers.
Yeah.
I guess that makes sense. Yeah, 600 is like 4%. If you're single, hit us up.
Okay. Is this what we resorted to, guys?
This is why we did the Kickstarter, for this very moment where we figured out the stats. And, yeah.
I mean, alright, so I woke up at like 5 p.m. today. And then I worked for 7 hours. You woke up at 11 p.m. and started casting. And you'll probably be up working until like...
Correction, if you're single and low maintenance.
Yes, I think that is the key point.
So we probably dropped from like 600 to maybe 4 or 5.
Yeah, and they probably don't live in the U.S.
Okay.
Sadly.
We may need to rethink our plan.
I think our plan sucks, guys. I think we're fucked.
Well,
good
thanks to Underer once again.
Someone posted on Reddit that I curse too much. What can I say? Right.
BTS needs more hot grills now that Blitz has left.
I have a George Foreman in the kitchen. And DPM has a grill as well. Korean barbecue grill. She does! That's what she has! You're the fucking worst, Kawa. Shut the fuck up.
We're the best.
Worst
around. I don't know any other lyrics of that song, but we're the best.
Alright. Three more to go. Random guy, 765. To LD and
you
guys.
You missed one.
Oh, did I?
Cello singer. You missed a Howl fanboy.
Cello singer. Well, I don't want to shout out for myself. It would be nice if you could get it to readmore.de and its community. Readmore.de is the biggest German esports site and is one of the best live tickers for Dota 2. Way better than ghost2gamers.net and joytodota.com. And an extra shout out to Nebu and Matty, doing an awesome job covering Dota 2 and putting so much effort into it. Thanks again for doing an amazing job covering Chinese Dota tournaments, and please keep on doing it. P.S. I'm a Hal fanboy. He should be fairly pleased. Hal is on
Tonker
the green
did well. I do doing well, so he's either way, he's doing great. So big thanks to you, Cello Singer, and those you don't know, the German esports followers, check out readmore.de. Our next shout out comes from randomguy765. You know you're a random guy when you have some generic number at the end of your name. So he says, to LD, gods, or whomever it may concern. This sounds like in a formal letter. Like, this is how I picture, like, when we're getting, I don't know, sued by Pyrian Flax for using his music
in
stream.
I don't think gods or gods with a Z really goes in a formal letter.
Maybe not. Okay. Well, he says, I received this email weeks ago and I really kind of forgot to fill it out. Well, we kind of really forgot to say them out.
Yeah. We'll call it even.
Yes.
Thank you.
He said he sat here at my /R battle station trying to figure out what all I can lob into here to help you both talk some crap about me. But hey, that's not why I donate. Basically, I really wish you both and whoever else is connected to this project all the best. I really hope this turns into something massive for all the Dota 2 and e-gaming community. Your Kickstarter video was inspirational to me and really pulled at my heartstrings. Enough bollocks now. Good luck with the studio. And if you ever need an Irish accent to accompany you on stream Sunday, you know where to come. Oh, and here. You want something to go, and I've already told you I'm Irish. Well, British for argument's sake. I'm from Belfast. 25. Been gaming for years. Retired Cal M 1.6 player. Yes, I did play versus Pub Masters. I'm pretty terrible, but I'm getting there.
He's probably a lot better now.
Yeah. And that's the other reason we took so long to do this, is so that when we say these guys are bad at Dota, they're actually no longer bad at Dota.
Shout out as well to a fellow former Cal M CS 1.6 player. I actually made it to Cal P, but I'm with you in arms, brother. The few, the proud, the brave. The Counter-Strike 1.6 players.
So if we ever need someone Irish, we need to talk to this guy.
Okay. Let's do it. And that brings up Ryba at the beginning of my screen. His name is Ryba. I don't know how you say that. Ziwa? Ryba Ziwa?
Yeah. Just Ryba, it sounds.
Ryba, okay. At the beginning of his nick means fish in Polish, and he can't swim.
Aww.
Well, rest is up to us. Really don't know what to add. If possible, shout out in my name for whole max-play.pl community as well. Reba.
I just want to say Reba. He's Polish, so I don't think it really works.
Yeah. Just made
big thanks to Reba from Poland and the Polish community there who support and watch Dota 2. Our last shout out, we've reached the end of the Kickstarter rewards from our magic wand, is coming from...
By the way, there were other people who selected this reward, but these are the ones that we got from you.
Yeah.
So if anybody else selected it, hasn't heard theirs got read, it's because you didn't provide us with anything. But if you do want to shout out, then please just... You can email us at bts@beyondthesummit.tv. Don't send us any dick pics, please, because we're just going to delete them. Anyway.
Our last one from Zulu Man. He says, I moderate SA I'm a big Dota fan and I write fiction as a hobby. If you remember anything about me beyond these basic facts, feel free to elaborate. I was bad casted once when you were figuring out this streaming business. I carried as Weaver with a Radiance to your co-caster surprise. Do you remember this game?
Yeah.
Zuluman, who played a Radiance Weaver?
Vaguely. This was...
Jason
okay, E-Sharp. So I actually started casting with something called the bad cast. So basically, this was like right when Dota 2 came out. Yep. So, first of all, the game was like kind of weird compared to Dota 1. Like the interface, the engine felt a lot different. There were a lot of bugs. But there was like matchmaking was funky. Like you'd get matched up, like you'd be like a Valve developer and get matched up against Dendi.
Yeah, yeah.
And you'd just get stomped. But yeah, I did the bad cast and drunkenly flamed people who are worse than me at Dota.
That's what he's
and here about. I am. So you too can drunkenly.
Now we drunkenly.
You too can drunkenly flame people who are worse than you at Dota and become a professional Dota broadcaster.
And once you're a professional Dota broadcaster, you can flame people drunkenly who are better than you at Dota.
Yes. Because and get paid.
Yeah.
Lots of money.
Oh, that's the best part. Oh,
lots of fucking money.
I love the money.
Where's my wallet? I need to show everyone how much money I have.
Oh.
I don't even have a wallet. Who am I kidding?
All right. Well. That does it. We're at the end of our shout, so a big thanks to everyone who did donate for that reward and to all the other rewards for our Kickstarter.
We do have one last shout-out. This comes from the Twitch chat. How haircut is looks so sexy. Every time I see him, I feel want to fuck him. Every time I dreamed of him before I sleep, I feel like I'm the only one luckiest guy on the world. That's our last shout-out.
And fuck Bulba.
Do something, Kawa.